I'm Mike.
I'm Faustine.
This is BYOB. Welcome to episode 2.
Let's go!
Round 2 in the Parc des Ecrins. Most of the tourists are down at the sea this time of year, so we come up to the mountains. We are here for a surprise birthday party for my father-in-law. He loves the sea, so we brought him up to the mountains just to fuck with him a little bit. Going to hike some of the craziest lakes in Europe that are only doable during the summer, and up to the top of Europe's tallest skiable glacier. Let's get into it.
To pay for that bloody music.
So the biggest bit of advice I can give you, if you come to Europe during the summer months, stay away from the beach. Unless you like being herded together like the walrus in that BBC episode where they all start falling off the cliff, you gotta come up to the cliffs. Not too many tourists up here in the summer. Great spot to get awesome deals on Airbnb chalets. So that's what we did. No camping for us in the chalet for Christian's birthday surprise. We all lied to him and said nobody was coming because of COVID-19. But obviously that wasn't true. We surprised him a little bit. And we had an absolutely fantastic time in the Airbnb for 4 nights. Albino camel toe. Or as we say back home in Canada, the albino moose knuckle.
Start the hoofing.
Where do they get a starting fine fee at 68?
To the top of the Lac du Lauvitel is absolutely amazing. 900 meters of vertical. 2 bits of advice: go early in the morning and treat it like the Chappelle show. You better not bring your kids.
Yellow brick road.
Yeah,
that's a lollipop.
So that's it. Look at that. It's like French Banff. They call it Framp Lake. Peter Frampton Lake. This is where Peter Frampton took DMT for 3 weeks and he decided he would put a tube in his mouth and attach it to his guitar. Fun times. Anyways, all seriousness, this blue lake's got us inspired. Hey, Faustine? Yeah, we're getting on our Sesame Street today. Yeah, the color of the day today is
blue.
So what are we gonna go do now?
Oh yeah, we're gonna pick up some blueberries.
Blueberry challenge. Let's go. So what's your strategy going into the challenge today?
So first of all, I'm gonna make sure I choose the best bush, and but all the blueberries are ripe. There's no cheating here. We don't grab the little ones here. It's only the ripe ones.
Do you think that George Bush was the best Bush? W. Bush, that is.
I don't want to get politically involved.
Precision of language, folks. It's all about that precision of language. Otherwise, people won't understand what you're saying. You know what I'm saying? Is there any advice that you could give any fellow competitor in the Blueberry Challenge?
Make sure you don't pick up the poisonous ones.
Ooh, and how do you know which ones are the poisonous ones?
I fucking know you.
Surprise! You have a diarrhea?
You try me.
Don't you put it in your mouth. Don't you put it in your mouth.
All right, Blueberry Challenge. We are in like blueberry fields forever here. There's blueberries all over the place. A few strawberries. If you get the odd strawberry in your basket, it does count.
No fucking young blueberries, yeah? They have to be adult and full and tasty.
Yo, there's plenty of young blueberries around here if you know what I mean.
All right, okay, let's fucking do it.
All right,
3, 2, 1,
go.
Hey!
Hey, why was the horse back
basket. After 21 minutes, I managed to get that. Mike got that, so I think it's pretty close, but from the weight, I'm a good player. I think he won. Mind you, there's a lot of leaves in it. There's no leaves on mine.
Are you giving me a disqualification?
I think I will.
Am I being different?
Oh yeah, that's a blueberry hands.
Looks like I have poor circulation.
Blueberries.
What's that? What? What are you saying? We can't hear you. Fucking idiot. This is what happens when you've been drinking for 3 days. You forget to turn the microphone on. So we were gonna let technology do all the hard work today. So we hop in the Tesla egg like Charlie and Willie. It was up, up, and away. And my girl is just like Eddie's girl. She likes to party all the time. Let's go. Can't hear you, you fucking idiot. I want to get off, Mr. Wonka.
I think we'll see the snow today.
Ooh. I don't think this is the closest to my birthday I've ever touched the snow. What did we learn today coming up here?
It's really easy to hike when you use technology.
Technology makes things easy. What else did we learn about technology?
It can be quite pricey.
It can be quite pricey? And what did we learn about aviation technology?
The drone in thin air doesn't fly too well.
Yeah, the drone looks pretty fucking scary, yeah? You think that you're about to lose $1,000 every 2 seconds.
Et voila! The crowning jewel of Les Deux Alpes 3600, so cleverly named after the height that the glacier sits at. This is Europe's highest skiable glacier, one of very few places that's still left in the Northern Hemisphere that has year-round skiing. People from all across the world enjoying snow park up at the top, loads of people just hitting jumps and jumps and jumps all morning. Really, there's nothing quite like this in the area. So the skiing is just one of two highlights up at the top. You got this little skinny, like metal mountain boner ledge thingy that they built. So you can go up there, take some nice photos.
if you hit it up in between midi et deux, 12 and 2. The French are like clockwork. They fucking disappear when it's lunchtime. So this is when I will say is the best time to come to the top of the hill. Warmest time of the day. Perfect time to just enjoy the views.
Photography technique I call let your wife freeze. You just get her to stand real still, and you take lots of photos in her glasses, and she gets real cold.
Oh, yeah.
All right, tell me something about Wayne Gretzky.
Hey,
you gotta talk to Jerry if you want the money, Faustine.
You look like fucking Bambi on his first day. Yeah, like when you walking up the snow, you're so unsure. You got like the legs super bowed out. It's incredible.
It's incredible.
Cute. And here we are. This is the fucking best, easiest hike I've ever done. I'm not tired yet. Even a little bit hungover this morning, but that seemed to go pretty well. Look at that. Skiing July the 20th. July the 20th. Y'all know who you are, yeah? You gotta get your asses over here. We gotta do this together, man. You gotta do it up. We'll go to the hospital, break our collarbones together, have some good old times, make some memories. Look at that. Beautiful. All right, we're gonna go get in the scary Willy Wonka train and get the fuck out of here. Look at Faustine. She's so uncertain on the snow. Look at her. Look at her. Fucking hell. Y'all right there, sweetheart?
Back down the hill we went towards Les Deux Alpes. Absolute fantastic place. You can stop off at a few different checkpoints with the gondola. This was our last day in France for episode 2 before we moved on to episode 3, which I'll talk about in a second.
Fucking golf course.
Mike is dreaming about the golf course right now.
Nah, I'm talking about snowboarding and shit. Fucking golf. You just don't want me to get hurt. Motherfuckers get injured all the time in golf. You know how many times Tiger Woods had a knee surgery or had his wife come at him with a fucking baseball bat?
Les Deux Alpes is definitely a place worthy of stopping by for a beer. If you have kids, this is the place to bring them, not up a 1,000-meter hike where they're gonna drive you nuts. This is all kinds of different games, attractions for both adults and kids, so a really, really cool place to hang out in the Alps. Like I said, while all the French tourists are down at the sea, we did loads of things on this trip. We got to get up to some waterfalls.
What do you want me to do? I saw it. That's it. I cannot go and swim in there, so it's no fun.
We get it. It's water. It's falling.
Beautiful.
What's so impressive about it? I mean, it's just gravity. You see gravity all the time, but when it's water that's falling, all of a sudden it's more beautiful.
It really was an awesome trip. From altitude lakes, birthday surprises, metallic mountain boners, gondolas, epic hikes, insane drone flights, we made a pie, and we got to see some of the last glaciers here in Europe. We got to eat a raclette in the summer, which some French would say, ça se fait pas. BYOB, the poor little fucker, he had altitude sickness and he kind of died.
Some say you're spoiling this plant. How do you respond?
Well, people spoil their children, so I spoil my plant.
Oh, burn in your face! Fuck your kids!
This was our bring your own basil experiment, and it failed. So basil in the Alps, not the place to bring it like you'd want to bring basil. Anyways, this was an absolute fantastic trip. Both sides of the Parc des Ecrins, well worth doing. You can do them all in one trip or do it like us, split it up, come back to both sides as you please. If you like this video, you know what to do. Down on the bottom, hit that button, turn on the notifications, all that nice stuff. We moved straight into episode 3 immediately once this was done, which was called Getting the Fuck Out of France and Going to Hang Out with People Our Own Age. Stay tuned.
Never enough subscribers and views and love.